What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Green Shorts Gaming. My name is AJ, and we're back at the Fisherman Village Town. No, actually, we're at the Waterfall of the Heavens. And for a good reason, because last two episodes, which were quite special, I separated out the berry gathering minigame, which we do with the little mouse huts down there, since we already got the Minita tunnel that shrinks us down, so you can access that. Just watch that video. And the other video is the ice pig robe challenge, where you turn all the evil pigs into ice candy and you give it over to the circus village. So yeah, I did those two, where I got the star, the golden star from the berry gathering challenge, and I also got extra adventure points from that circus village pig where we gave those mini pigs. So go watch that if you want to know how to do that. It should help you accomplish those achievements or those goals. Anyway, so we're here too because I wanted to grab this real quick, and because I just love the area. So these are adventure chests. And this is where I saved anyway, so yeah, I saved over here right after completing the challenges. And I wanted to grab this blue chest real quick and hopefully not fall. Oh, I did. Never mind. So, sorry about that. So I realized in the last episode in the water temple, we still had a pig bag to get. I mean, we were way ahead of ourselves when we defeated the evil ghost pig, but that was fun, actually going into the actually beating him and going into the hidden tower and grabbing this awesome torch hammer. So I wanted to unlock this area too, right here. If you guys didn't know, you could just use a grappling hook here and show you guys where this evil piggy is. I hope I don't fly into it right away. Is he up here? Should be up here. Alright, never mind. That's the water pig, actually. Which brings me to my point. We have to go to the water temple and unlock that area up there. That's where the water pig will be. So, we have to find the pig bag. And to do that, we need to talk to giant fish. So that's gonna be the main goal. We're not gonna be defeating any other evil pigs right now. We're just gonna grab the pig bag. Which is essentially completing this level, which we should have done last time, but I felt like we needed to do something different for a change, and that's gonna help anyway for later on. It's not like we didn't do any progress. We beat the ice pig already, so that's good. So what you want to do is talk to this mermaid again. She's gonna tell you we need a harp.
Thank you.
Something.
What is?
You said this place was also cursed by evil pig magic. If so, there should be an evil pig bag here somewhere. Do you know anything about this?
We'll need to wake the giant fish, the guardian deity of the water temple. Pretty hard task right now. To wake up the giant fish, I'll need my harp. But when the water pigs shut me away, they took that too. You aren't actually planning to go look for it, are you?
We have to.
Thank you so much. When they took the harp from me, I watched them disassemble it into four parts. They took the harp's right side, the harp's left side, the high. They threw the pieces in the.
Yeah, they threw it away. And there's a glitch here. I don't know if it's a glitch or if you really have to do these in sequence, but the right side of the harp usually is in this corner right here, but it's not. I think it only appears when you have certain items, like the white key, which we don't have yet, and when this mermaid gets out of the way, like she actually swims up to the giant fish. So what we're gonna do is go over here, and since we're here, let's talk to this guy, so we don't, you know, forget.
Wow, it's dark and I can't see a thing.
so we can get extra adventure points anyway.
Hey, is anybody there? I stumbled into this room. It's pitch dark and I can't... You need more than a little light.
Oh, we can help you with that. 20 snow fireflies? There you go. So this is what this is for. Fireflies? Right? I can say words.
Yeah, that was right. So those were the famous snow fireflies.
Yeah, that was right. Yeah.
Are you all right?
Yes, thanks so much. I thought I would never get out. I've come looking for the chest of wisdom, but it doesn't look like it's here either.
Is that what you're standing on right there? Huh?
This is the chest of wisdom. It was so dark, I completely missed it.
It's like the only not flat thing in the room.
Let's try to open it.
Just, yeah, open it. There you go, and we got the wisdom spell.
It's the self. You should memorize. Climb aboard that other mechanism, and you can get holy water.
Yep, we already know. We already finished that part. So, we're talking to that guy. We already got half the spell of wisdom. Or chant of wisdom, song of wisdom, whatever. It's gonna be helpful for later on. Because there's an item in this game that is so awesome. We have to get it before we fight all the evil pigs. Or at least the last evil pig. So up here is one of the parts of the harp she was talking about. Which is why we're heading over here, even though we already beat the evil pig. First, I want to do this. And the pig nose panels that we just got from the AP chest go over here. But I think we're a little short on AP. We need 2 million to grab the last one. So, we're just gonna keep racking up points. Here's the harp's right side. Just drop down here. Grab those. Kill that. Grab this. Those. And let's head over and grab us the white key. Oops. Excuse me. And it's useful to have a hammer over here. Because you can just whack stuff out of your way. You can either have the hammer or the, boomerang. To grab stuff that you might have missed. Oh shoot, I thought I already cleared the third one. Anyway, here we go. And this is like a loading spot, so you have to go through that white screen every time you pass through. This guy has a white key, so we're gonna just hit that switch right there, get rid of those troublesome platforms, and grab the white key from this adventurer. See what he has to say.
Wow, look how high up it's placed. I could never have done that myself.
Of course not. You're not Tomba. You don't have the jumps.
Now, at last, I'm ready to ship my cargo. All I have to do now is load it on the raft.
Sure, go ahead. That's your raft? Cool. Good thing it's not floating away or anything.
This is way too heavy.
Too heavy?
I've got it. For helping me out.
Sure, thanks, man. He just gave us the chest that he was guarding this whole time he was stuck. It's like, alright, I don't care about the chest anyway, I just want to go home. Alright, there we go. White key. And so we got those. Can I grab it? Nope, I cannot. So the white key is essential for grabbing. Whoa. Grabbing the parts of the harp. This is one of them right here. Alright, the low pitch pearl. So let's see what we got so far. So we got the low pitch pearl, the high pitch pearl, and the harp's right side. Okay. The harp's left side was in that room where that we saved that mermaid from, you know, from being trapped. And when we went to the actual area, it was in the corner, it wasn't there. What you want to do is grab the white key, make sure you got all the harp parts, and you actually go up here and initiate the sequence.
Wow, that's one big fish, but it looks...
Giant fish is sleeping. This has to happen from my experience, because...
The giant fish won't wake up until he hears my harp.
Because it just doesn't show up. And in my playthrough, at least. So if ever this happens to you and the harp doesn't show up, just keep talking to this lady. Talk to her twice. She'll tell you where the harps are. Which harp parts are missing, and hopefully, having done that, all the missing harp piece will be in that room where she just left. Hopefully. Let's grab this apple. Yum. Yummy apples. Love apples. Love me some apples. Alright. Let's go down. That mermaid that just talked to us up where the great fish is the same mermaid that was stuck in this room. Now she's gone. Hopefully. Yes, there we go. Awesome. So, if you remember, we were right here in the beginning when she was in the room, but it doesn't appear until she actually swims up to the giant fish. So the game expects you to talk to the discover the giant fish first. After saving that little mermaid. Ha! Alright, cool. I'm so happy now. I thought that was like a glitch or something, but apparently a sequence of events requires you to complete it first before you see the actual piece of the harp, which is kind of tricky. Especially if you finish this game already and you're like, huh, I could have sworn it was right there. But I guess if you're playing this game for the first time, you would have gone up here first and explored. I guess. Alright, so we got all the harp pieces. And we can talk to the mermaid again. Here you go, lady. Here's your precious harp.
What a surprise!
I bet she just dropped the part
the
when she left.
Is back in one piece. I'm so happy.
Really?
Okay, stand back. I'm going to wake the big fish.
Okay, cool. I'm so excited. Yay. And we did it. So this is the guardian fish. It looks like a giant carp.
Look at that. The fish is awake. But now what do we do?
This is all I can do.
That's all she did.
Now all you have to do is see whether the big fish will notice you.
Just act like a lure. Wear something shiny. Hey, buddy. How you doing? What's up? Cool. He noticed us. Senpai noticed me. The senpai fish. Rumble, rumble, rumble.
This is a great temple.
Whoa.
Go see it with your own eyes.
That was amazing. Alright. So let's go in here. And hopefully... to this guy.
Welcome to my presence.
My presence.
You have been noticed by the big fish.
Are you the big fish? Did you turn into a person?
I welcome you as representatives of my temple people.
Okay.
The reason for your coming is to search for the evil pig bag.
Are you Poseidon?
First, look at this.
A Okay. Oh, I've seen one of those.
Is that the egg of a coca bird?
We've seen that before.
Now then, come up and crack the egg.
Yeah, there's something in there, isn't there? Okay.
What's this?
It's called the mystery reflector.
Mystery.
It is part of the mechanism for opening the door holding the pig bag.
Okay.
For camouflage, I disguised the bird egg in a different shell. But that one was destroyed.
Was that
the coca bird took one other egg away with it.
I mistook it for the real one.
Exactly. But where did the coca bird take it?
We got it. It was at the Kajara Ranch, at the rightmost side where we got those fireflies.
To operate this mechanism, we need two mystery reflectors. Without both of them together, it's useless.
And he's just gonna walk across like a boss, and we can't. We have to go follow the path, follow the carpet, because we don't want to desecrate the temple with our dirty feet.
Absolutely. This is the reflector.
Oh yeah.
Now set it on the...
There you go.
Next, open up the skylight.
You do it. I have no idea how to do that.
Whoever gets the pig bag, make sure you don't look into the light.
Don't look into the light. It'll turn it... I wonder if this is how evil pigs were born. Like, if you look into the light, you turn into an evil pig. Or maybe you just turn into a giant fish. I don't know. Alright, let's go in there. Oh. Go grab the evil pig bag. The evil water pig. There we go. Awesome sauce. So now we got the evil pig bag for the water pig. Now we can actually go to that area at the starting beach, the waterfall of the heavens, and kill us some piggies. Or trap us some piggies. They don't die, they just get sealed away in a purse forever. Which may be a fate worse than death. And now we're back. Now you see why I started the episode over here, so it makes sense. So, there you go. There you have it. The evil water pig is up here. You can either fly up here, glide, or you can just do this with a grappling hook. Hopefully. Did I unlock it? Did I unlock it? It should be up here. There we go. So, we're gonna beat evil water pig real quick, and that should be the end of the episode. What are we gonna use? I'm gonna use this. Doesn't make sense. Fire against water. Yeah. Alright. Let's do this. I don't remember if I said we weren't gonna defeat an evil pig in this episode, but since we have time, we can just do that right now. I think this is one of the fancier of the evil pigs. Never mind.
The evil water pig makes her grand.
Apparently it's a lady.
What?
She referred to herself as a her. Even though she doesn't sound like one.
You, what a funny face you got.
What a funny face you got. Stupid dress. Ugly face.
Don't make me laugh. My jaw's about to fall off.
You sound high. Okay. Oh my god. Probably is.
Alright. Water face on. Water.
Okay. This was like my first episode where his voice wasn't loud enough to be heard. Oh, excuse me, lady. Excuse me, ugly lady. Apparently, you can't reach him from... There we go. Get him from right here. It's a good thing we can swim. Oh, man. There we go. This is pretty easy because the pig bag is right there in the middle. I think something happens every time we trap him. Oh, excuse me. I seem to remember water getting closer. Hold on. Forgot our health's going down. Do we have any more sandwiches? We got a steak sandwich. Let's use it. I try not to use any health stuff, but I'm not a pro. I'm no pro. I just like playing the game. Yeah, there we go. One more time. Ah, there we go. Water's getting closer. Doesn't matter. That's pretty cool, actually, that effect right there. We only need one more hit. Boom. And you're gone. Well, that was easy. We didn't even miss. Not like the ice pig we fought. Maybe it's because the pig bag was closer. There you go. Now we got the evil water pig robe. Which makes it
you
rain.
Did it, Tomba.
I guess.
Put on this robe and you can
equip
the robe on the item screen.
Use it wisely
though. The mat. And what's this? The evil water pig robe.
Everything's changing. And now it's not raining anymore, and the water's calm. That's cool. So the reason why this isn't how it's supposed to look like, it's like whenever you cure a place of the evil spell, it's supposed to do like a little swirly thing. I am currently playing, I have the original disc in the disc drive on my computer right now. The reason why is because the graphics look sharper. I'm using an emulator. I have a PS1 console that I'm gonna probably show in a future episode, but I tried using the Elgato game capture with that and it just looks crappy. Whenever I use the emulator with the actual disc though, which is what I'm doing right now, it looks pretty good. The colors are accurate, bright, and all the angles, you can actually see, you know, the lines of the game. And this is how I remember it when I first played it on the old CRT televisions. But yeah, that's it for this episode. We beat an evil pig. And look at Tomba's butt. And we got a bunch of stuff. Next episode, since we got all the pig bags, we can actually do a little more free play like we did last time. Maybe we'll unlock the hidden temples, hidden towers, you know? Maybe we'll do that. I actually have an idea of what to do next episode, but you'll just have to wait to see. So, yeah. That's it. I'm just gonna leave you guys with Tomba's butt twerking right here. Twerk, twerk. Anyway, thanks for watching Green Shorts Gaming. My name is AJ. And if you like Tomba's twerking, you know, leave a like in the video. Comment in the comment section below. And maybe subscribe. Alright. Enjoy the twerking.